the pre-analytical error. Pre-analytical error constitutes around 66% of errors. That means majority of the errors are covered there. As per ISO, there is a thing which is called traceability control. I'll give you an example. Once a patient came to me and said, "Sir, can you prove that the blood which I have given is reaching you?" A very genuine question. I simply said, "Yes, I know that your blood is reaching me." "Then how it is reaching you, sir?" And there is a thing which is called traceability control. And that traceability control is not taken care by majority of us. And there lies the lacuna of a wrong sample going to and a wrong report generated. This is the first error, which is called pre-analytical error. Number second, the proper collection. Many a times, I get from the networking labs a sample for factor 8 or factor 9. Very sorry to say, in a red cap plain tube. And they argue even. When I meet them, they say, "This is the method done there." It is a lie, definitely a lie. But one, the staff who is a phlebotomist should not be taught how to run an EDP. There should be a categorization there only. Because I have a laboratory which is a totally different setup which madam is dealing. Or Dr. Gupta is coming from a premier medical college, although he has a private practice. But he is also having a huge setup of a medical college. I come from a garage practitioner. I started from my garage of my father with two or three patients per day. My experience is from the grassroots, from the scratch, with no advertisement, with nothing. I can share you the grassroots problems which I say the pre-analytical errors. Number one is the name. Second is a wrong collection. If the phlebotomist doesn't know how much to collect and how much to keep in that vial or how much to keep in that vacutainer, there lies your problem. One should use the costliest vacutainers available in India to see and compare with the Indian vacutainers or other brands and find himself or herself which is the best. Don't depend what the phlebotomists say. In the staff category, we must categorize them into different sections. In ma'am's setup, it is not possible for ma'am to do all the tests, or all the PG students or everyone should do the test. It is not possible, acceptable. But in a small setup like mine, I am competent enough, I think, to handle at least 100 cases in which it is 50% shared by my missus, who is also a doctor. Therefore, two people can easily run a lab with the assistance and can deal at least 100 patients. I think this should be one of the judgment which I call a pre-analytical error. We don't know our limit. We always think that sky is the limit with automation. No. I will still say, limit yourself in your practice, be genuine, and there is automation which is a boon in this era. The third thing in the pre-analytical error is with a hemolyzed sample, we also try to perform a serum potassium. And because we have never seen that sample, the doctor has never seen that sample and gets a report of 5.75. The same thing repeated after 2 hours is 3.98. And the doctor has never seen the sample. That is also a pre-analytical error, which none of the accreditation body is writing, but it should be written. The human eye is the best eye, and being a doctor, it is your duty to screen each and every sample and reject it accordingly before blaming the automation the fault. Because the machine, the what you will put in the machine will deliver you. Therefore, you cannot blame the instrument each and every time.